Hi, in this video, we'll explore the open source tool called Polaris. Before doing that, let's install to the cluster. So we'll create a managed KTS cluster using Civo CLI. So the command is fairly simple, Civo K3S create --7--wait--applications. And we want to install Polaris. So this will install the Polaris application from the marketplace, which is the Civo marketplace. So we can see that it has started creating a 3-node K3S cluster G2 medium instance called Snowy Abyss. And so let the cluster get created and let's go back to see what Polaris is. So basically it has a lot of inbuilt checks that helps you run your pod and the controllers and all the deployment YAML files consistently, reliably, and according to the best practices. So that you can avoid any future problems with respect to all the securities and the best practices scenarios. There are three different modes in which you can run, which is, one is the dashboard mode. That is what we have just installed. So we have installed it as a deployment and we'll be able to access the dashboard. Next is the validating webhook. So that automatically when you create a deployment or a YAML file, so if it's not respecting whatever the checks are there by Polaris, it will not even get deployed to the cluster. Third is the command line tool. So let's see what the command line tool is. So the installation guide is fairly simple. I already have Polaris installed. So it helps you to actually run the checks against any local YAML files as well. So even before committing the things to GitHub, you can validate those using Polaris CLI. Let's see how that works. So I have this Polaris already there. So what we'll do is Polaris audit and --- audit path. I have a demo pod. So it'll go through it and run the checks. So you can see that it has inspected that there is a pod and it has given us a lot of results. The name is there. A lot of things are not set, like the CPU limits are missing requests are missing, liveness probe is missing, and memory limits requests are missing. So all these things are missing. And this is actually we can check before we are actually deploying anything out of the cluster. So it gives the benefit of deploying proper applications or proper deployments to the cluster, or while you are in development phase, this tool, this particular CLI will definitely help over there. I think that's pretty much it. There are other things that you can do with the CLI. I think we can see the usage as well. Command line tool. Yeah, so using the usage guide, you can see. So there are different perspectives, security, reliability, efficiency. You can create actually your own custom checks as well. So this is interesting. So you can create your custom checks as well. And you can exempt a deployment from the Polaris check. So that also you can do by annotating the deployment, which is another cool thing. So let's go to our dashboard and see the cluster. So our cluster is almost created. So once the application is installed by the marketplace, you get the post-install instructions like how to access the UI or dashboard with respect to the applications. So for Polaris, it's just a simple port forward command. We'll just copy it and we'll see. And yes, our cluster is already getting created. Before running this command, we actually have to set the context. So let's set the context first. So we have switched the context to use the cluster that we just created. And now we'll do the port forward. So let's copy this and do the port forwarding. And now we should be able to access. So you can see the Polaris cluster overview. So how many checks passed, how many checks failed, the warnings, and all the namespaces filter by namespace, filter by the deployments, and actually we can expand them. So if you see, like in the namespace in Polaris, the Polaris dashboard is there, and all the checks are passed over here. So all the basic checks that Polaris has been configured to adhere to with the proper best practices. So the CP limits are set, the requests are set, host path is not configured, container does not have any dangerous capabilities, insecure capabilities, all these are checked over here. Now let's see one of our deployments where these things are not there. Since this is a K3s cluster, some of the things, doesn't really need to be in the same state that is expected. But still, most of the checks, you should be able to see how things should be. So like file system should be read only. Again, the basic checks should be there, like a CPU limit, CPU requests. So like this, you get a complete cluster overview, and then you are able to see what all things are wrong in the cluster. Basically not wrong, what all is deployed in the cluster that we have not seen. We have not deployed according to the best practices. And we can solve that. Also, if we see kubectl get deploy, so we have the Polaris dashboard over here, and get deploy Polaris, and we can see the YAML file to see what all things are there and how it got deployed, the Polaris and the dashboard. There are the checks and all that can be disabled as well. So those configurations can be provided. The checks can be disabled. Some of the checks can be enabled. So from the docs, these things can be taken care. So that's it for Polaris. Simple tool, but efficient. It is actively developed, and the last release was on 9th of August, but we can see the commits happening. So fairly maintained and good for even local YAML files and even as a dashboard to get a complete cluster overview. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching.